are the scribers. We receive the cores and we look at them very closely, and then we try to identify features that might help us to understand the depositional environments and how the sediments were deposited and how they evolved through time. So for that, we look at the grain size, whether it's fine grain or coarse grain. If it is coarse grain, you likely needed a lot of energy to transport that grain. And if it was fine grain, it was probably slowly and calmly deposited. We also look at the color to see if it's gray or green, and that reveals a lot about the mineral content. For example, if it has a lot of silica, quartz, it will be light gray, and if it has a lot of carbonates, it could be beige in color. So color varies depending on the composition of the rock. We also look at what the organisms do, like if you have creatures that are eating up the soil because they are hungry, then they leave marks, and we call those marks bioturbation. And the houses in which the creatures live are called burrows. And different creatures have different burrows and leave different tracks of their activities. So we analyze those tracks and the burrows to try to learn about who live there. Most of the time we also have fossils, and they can be broken shells, so they can be whole shells. And the shells tell us something about the environment in which those organisms live. For example, some organisms live in shallow water, some live in deep water. So by knowing who live where and why are they in the sediments, we can learn about the environment of deposition.